Welcome back. 6:25 is your time right now. We are just 16 days away from Super Bowl 53. The big game is being played, of course, at Mercedes-Benz Stadium right here in Atlanta. The best place to watch is right where you are in your home right here on CBS 46. So a lot of us will be watching the game at home Sunday night. You might be hosting a party. Well, this morning, Parker Wallace has some unique and tasty appetizers for us. And Parker, you're certainly a lifestyle and food expert, a foodie in town. It's easy to be a foodie in Metro Atlanta, right?
It sure is. Yeah.
So tell us what you have.
Yeah, so I created these recipes for the Georgia Beef Board, and I'm all about amping up the flavor, but keeping it hassle-free, Tracy.
That's what
so
we like.
So meatballs are a showstopper when you take them to the next level by, frying them with cheese inside.
Okay.
What's up? Okay. And then let's just take it up a notch and wrap the meatball in puff pastry.
Yeah,
so this is like a buffalo flavored meatball wrapped in pastry, and I'm going to show you how easy it is. So we're taking a partially cooked meatball, do the little
kind of like a cookie cutter, right?
Yeah, it's like a little biscuit cutter. So you do the circle and you pop it on top like this with the second circle, and then you're just gonna press it down and around.
And this is a pastry you could buy at the store, the pie.
Listen, who has time to make pastry?
I haven't made one in a very long time.
Exactly, yeah, do the store-bought, it keeps it simple. And then once you push it around, form it into a little ball, you're just gonna brush it with a little bit of egg wash like this.
Okay.
And then again, we've kind of partially cooked.
That's gonna give it the
golden crust. Yes, we've partially cooked them. And then that's just gonna bake off for about 20 more minutes, and it's gonna be this beautiful golden pastry that you can open up, and it's all ricotta and the ground beef and the seasonings. So it's really like the perfect bite of delicious.
Yeah, and people will rave about your Super Bowl party for years to come.
Yes, and let's just look at the panko encrusted sage and ricotta in there. You see all of that juicy flavor. Keep it tender. Don't overwork the meat because it'll get tough.
Okay.
Okay, so now let's talk about a really easy to assemble beef appetizer. You don't have to cook a thing.
All right, really
quickly. Except sauteing some onions.
Okay.
Yep. We're gonna do a little bit of horseradish creme fraiche on here, just mayo and horseradish. Pop a little bit of roast beef on top, your favorite kind. Then some caramelized onions, and this is just sauteing onions in a little bit of wine and butter for about 30 minutes.
It makes them taste so good.
Oh my gosh, it's like candied onions.
They smell so good too.
Right, yeah. And then a little bit of gorgonzola or blue cheese, and then a pop of green with some spring onions.
Because you always want that color on there, and finger food is really the key to having a great Super Bowl party.
Exactly, right? And so you get all of that texture, the crunch, the delicious savoriness of the roast beef with the sweetness of that caramelized onion, and then, of course, that yummy creamy cheese.
Right, and really
then,
quick, we have
Yes. Okay, Philly cheesesteaks. Literally 8 minutes in the Instant Pot. Saute that, whatever steak you want to use. I used ribeye. And then look at all of that melty deliciousness.
Perfect.
Stunning.
Parker, thank you so much. We're going to have our own little Super Bowl spread here, I think. Thank you. Of course, CBS 46 this morning. We'll be back right after this.
You're watching CBS 46, home of Super Bowl 53.